There's few number theoretical concepts that have captivated mathematicians and even popular culture as much as prime numbers. In the book Contact by Carl Sagan and the movie based on it with the same name, the signals used by the extraterrestrial beings were pulse patterns of prime numbers. Why? Because their existence and importance is seen to transcend language and culture, so that if we ever did see these kinds of patterns, we'd be certain that they weren't the result of random noise and that something intelligent was behind them. But what's the best way to define a prime number, and how do we find them? We can classify whole numbers, that's the positive counting numbers along with the number zero, as being prime or not based on the number of factors. A prime number has exactly two factors, itself and one. Interestingly, we don't actually include the number one as a prime number. According to the definition, one isn't prime because it's only got one factor. But mathematicians have actually argued about this definition for centuries, so the exclusion of one is a deliberate and human-made decision. Another way of defining primes is in terms of whether or not a whole number can be expressed as the product of two smaller numbers. So the number 6 is not prime because I can express it as 2 times 3. The number 7, on the other hand, can only be achieved as a product of whole numbers using itself along with 1. How would the number 1 fit in here? In this case, you'd say that 1 can't be expressed as the product of two smaller numbers. So, why wouldn't we include it? Well, the mathematicians still don't want to, so this definition is usually expressed something like a prime number is any number greater than 1 which cannot be represented as the product of prime numbers. Actually, the decision about 1 probably comes down to a theorem that mathematicians are very proud of. It goes like this: every whole number is either prime itself or can be expressed uniquely as the product of primes up to rearrangement. Let's unpack that. So the number 12 is not prime because it can be expressed as 2 times 2 times 3, with 2 and 3 being prime numbers. The unique and up to rearrangement part means that 12 can't be expressed any other way other than by changing the order. So 7 is prime, 6 is not, 8 is not, and 13 is. Numbers that can be expressed as a product of primes are called composite numbers, and this decomposition of a number into this product is called its prime factorization. So as well as referring to numbers as either prime or composite, we can also describe a number's factors as being either prime factors if they are included in the prime factorization, or composite factors. What kind of issues does one cause here? Well, we know that 1 can't be a composite number because we can't express it as a product of other prime numbers. But what if 1 were a prime number? Well, that ruins the whole uniqueness of the prime factorization. For example, we could then express 12 as 2 times 2 times 3, or as 1 times 2 times 2 times 3, or as 1 times 1 times 2 times 3. Actually, there would be infinitely many ways of expressing the number 12 as the product of prime numbers. Some would argue it's for the sake of this theorem that we exclude 1. So, the theorem is stated, every whole number greater than 1 is either prime or can be expressed uniquely as the product of primes up to rearrangement. It's been proven that we never run out of prime numbers, and actually, even as we get larger and larger numbers and we think there should be a higher chance of being able to find factors, we can still find primes that are either side of an even number. Primes this close together are referred to as twin primes, and we never run out of them either. A related concept that we'll touch on in this topic is that of two numbers being relatively prime. This is a relationship between two numbers based on their common factors. Essentially, every number has one as a factor, but if this is the only common factor between two numbers, then we say that they are relatively prime. So even though neither 10 nor 21 are prime numbers, because they don't have any common factors other than 1, we say that they are relatively prime. Of course, if we wanted to avoid talking about 1, as seems to be the habit of mathematicians, we could just say that two numbers are relatively prime if they share no prime factors.